Hello, and welcome to Professional Dance Tips for Professional Dancers in a Professional Setting with Ogden Bradley, also known as PDT, P... Are you ready to move? I've got on a black polo, nice khaki pants, a belt, and a necklace. Some people say, Ogden, why don't you wear a tie? You look so trashy. And I say, because I do what I want, I wear a necklace. Okay? It's as simple as that. Dancing is about freedom of speech and expressionism, and also looking your greatest. So make sure you get out there and you buy yourself what you feel comfortable in to dance with.
Explosion.
Let's get to the dance moves. The first dance move is easily the most easily learned. It's also the basis for many of my dances. It's called the roundhouse. Arms up in running position, foot out, foot back. Other foot out, other foot back. Now, the more advanced people will swing their arms when they move, but it's not necessary. Watch. Great, cool. The next move that you will learn is easily one of the easiest moves to learn. It's called a fist hump. Now, you may ask, why not fist bump or why not just regular hump? And I say, it's because I've combined them two into one. And so here's all you need to do. First, you need to fist pump. Next, all you need to do is hump. And when you combine them, you get the fist hump. Now, the most important part of the fist hump is that you announce to the audience afterwards how many you did. For example, let's try again. It's easily interconnectable with many other dance moves. The third dance move is easy. It's probably the easiest dance move to learn in the world. All you need to do is stand like a pole and blow in the wind. Oh, that's harsh wind. The next move is easy to do also. It's probably the second or third hardest move to do in the whole world. It's okay though, you can learn it. So here it is. It's called the wave and look. See how I'm looking but also not looking and waving my arm? That's the move.
Dancing.
Let's get into some dance starters, finishers, and middlers, also known as fill-ins. Okay? I like to start a lot of my dances with isolation. Isolation is where you use one part of your body and only move that part. I like to add in a little trick by pointing to whatever body part that I'm moving at the time so that it seems a lot more cool. For example, when the song is getting going, people can see that you're also getting going, and it makes it for a really easy dance move that you can just add into anything. Another dance move that you can use, perhaps in the middle of your dance, is a filler I like to call sea walking. As far as I can tell, all you do is move your feet like this. You can throw that into any dance that you know. I know I do. And then for the finisher, my favorite finisher move for the dance is definitely just to look at whoever or whatever I'm dancing with and stare at it like this. It really adds in that, hey, where do you have a connection tonight? You should probably let me know where your house is type feel. Or, hey, I'm so professional, you might want to hire me for your next big movie. Maybe it's either one of those. The choice is yours.
Let's get to it.
Baby, can't you see?